Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So we're back playing with the patrol. We have just taken it up for engineering. It did fail. I knew that it was going to fail. There was no way in the world it was going to pass. I just knew that there was going to be something, and well, there was. Six little things, two of which were oversights. Airbag light, which took as simple as a scan tool to clear the airbag code, whatever it was, which cleared that and fixed that. The other one was ABS. Now, because the dash, the wiring loom, and all the other stuff was out of the 2011, it had ABS, and the car itself doesn't. So basically just had to delete that from the system so that it's sorted. It's just saying that it wasn't working because plain and simply, it wasn't there. The ABS module under the bonnet wasn't there because it's not part of the system in it anymore. One of the other things was suspension. Now, it's got 3-inch flexi Dobinson coils, and we've got 4-inch Dobinson MRR adjustable shocks in it. It's got all heavy duty arms, adjustable panhards, all of that stuff, and return to center front shock and steering shock and all that kind of stuff. Beyond all that, the shocks were straight out of the box. They were pretty much on their softest settings they had. Another oversight with everything that's going on, didn't even think about the fact that it had to pass a swerve or a lane change test or anything like that. And basically, dual cab stuff meant the engine conversion stuff, perfect apparently. It's too noisy. There's too much turbo noise coming out of the snorkel, so I have to quieten that down a little bit, put in some baffles or something. And exhaust noise under full noise is okay, it passes, but he said probably quieten it down a little bit as well. So I do have the adjustable Varax muffler on the back of this. Well, it's actually in the middle, and I will half shut that, fix the issues with that. So pretty successful. The shock change absolutely dramatically changed the way this car handles. I cannot believe the difference that just changing the shock rebound and the other adjustments on it made. Just phenomenal. This thing just handles so much better now on the road. It will be way different off-road. It is quite stiff on the road now, but beyond that, I'm just going to take it in, put on the hoist now, and take the rear coils out, put in these Airbag Man rear airbags, and go from there, I suppose. See how it all goes. God, this thing goes good. So I've got her on the hoist now, just the back's up in the air. It is something I have tried in the past, just using a single arm, just to lift, if you just need to lift a little bit. Done it a couple of times. I trust it now, so rather than have to lift the whole car up. Anyway, we have the airbag kit over here, I'll show you. So this is the airbag kit we got. We got airbag man, heavy duties. They are Firestone bags. That's actually the kit there I got. It comes with all of the line already in the sheathing. Comes with all the fittings, zip ties and all that stuff. Also, all the product manual, fitting guide, all that stuff, registration. And the best part of all that I liked, comes with a little book to actually put it in the glove box with the owner's manual and so on. So, next, I have to pull the lower suspension's shocks off and allow the diff to drop down a little bit. I'm going to drop the coils out and we'll fit these inside it. As for the fitting guide, it says to get a short piece with this red valve. Now, if you have a look, trying to get this into the air, it's starting to pull back the cover, and that's about as deep as I can get it comfortably. Now, what I'm going to try is deflating the bag, installing this so it doesn't actually reinflate, and then I'm going to try and refit it. I'm going to just start with depressing the bag from as much air as I possibly can, comfortably. Installing that. Now the bag's deflated completely, so I will attempt to fit this now. So I did just quickly pump that up a little bit. It is now fully installed. To release that, you just push down on the little collar, pull the little piece off. We'll move on to the next one now. And again, we're going to just repeat. Just going to put that into that pipe. We're just going to squish down the airbag. Get as much air out as we can comfortably. Now that's fully depressed again. Flip that straight into there. Now, just going to double check and make sure it's all going in nicely. Again, trying to keep it as close to the top as we can. Has seated it quite nicely actually. We'll just grab these and just help this up just a little bit because it's very difficult to grab hold of with my hand. So and again, push down the little collar, release nice and easy. So I've marked the location. I'm actually going to put them in here, one on each side, left and right, obviously, for the airbags. Now, I'm not sure. I kind of want to put them on the same side in the same spot, but I might end up, I don't know, one there and one there, obviously, left and right. I'm not too sure yet. I might sleep on it, but that's the plan, is to put one on each side for these. They're the little air valve, as you call it, with the fitting on the back of it, and they screw through to have to pump them up. So I'm just about to pack up, but yeah, both sides, not sure yet, because I want to run an air tank under here with a compressor, and I might end up putting an outlet there, and I might put both of them on that side. We'll see. We'll come back to this.
We've opted for the twin on the one side. Thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe, and yeah, can't wait to jump into the next video and get the rest of this rig sorted, get it all finished and yeah, dialed in. Thanks, guys. Some things never change. I couldn't stop and say no.